This time he's gone too far. Eclipse the motor car. Yet strangely here we are. A friend is still a friend. Our challenge has begun to undo what he's done.
A felon on the run.
A friend is still a friend.
But if he's heading homeward, alas, I fear the worst. With the stoats and weasels there, we have to find him first.
We won't live with regret. The fight's not over yet. So let us not forget a friend. He's still a friend.
Oh, Mr. Engine Driver! Make it faster, take me thither, I've a family to feed. This disaster, if we dither, can you build up more speed?
There's no hurry, I just swallowed, all you told me is true. That's a worry, we're being followed by a Kalamazoo.
And as the fields we passed became a blur, we were in hot pursuit of him slash her.
He used his wit and cunning, and a washerwoman's cape.
A fine charade with which he made the greatest race escape.
So why were you in prison?
For nothing! A mere bagatelle. I borrowed a motor car while the owner was at lunch.
But they're gaining, I'm no joking, they are closing the gap.
Stop complaining, just keep stoking. Chop chop, there's a good chap.
But they're quicker, and they're lighter, we are losing control.
Let's not bicker, I'm a fighter. Just keep shoveling coal!
With a good head of steam, we went full pelt. Certain the toad would have his collar felt.
Could you jump from the train, do you think?
Well, might you be able to stop?
Of course I can't stop. They're bearing down on us like a wolf on the fold. I'll hold the brakes lightly and you get ready.
Well, how exactly would I?
Like this.
Ooh. And as the train's raced on, the pistons hissed. There was a toad.
It may have lacked decorum, but a farce was taking shape.
That talked about what was no doubt the greatest great escape. We must find him, we must catch him, though we're losing the scent. Those behind him, we can match him.
We don't know where he went.
This is silly and confusing, but he's running a mob. Humiliating losing to a toad in a frock.
Life goes by with a clippity-clop, clippity-clop. You choose where and when you should stop. The open road was somewhat mental. I swapped it for a life without the roar of traffic. A lighter load, a pace that's gentle, is certain to impress an elder demographic.
So, you're in washing business.
Washing, ironing, starching, all the gentry come to me.
And you enjoy it?
I simply dote on it, but then I have a talent for it.
Well, then that's a bit of luck. Look at that pile of washing over there.
Never mind the washing, what's for lunch?
Oh, poo's a lunch. Think of the fun in store for you. There's the tub and the soap and the kettle, all set up for a day of joy.
Well, if it comes to that, I suppose anyone can wash.
To be messing about in a boat on the river with you doing me wash. It's one of those chores I prefer some old scrubber to do, splishity splosh. As you will note with the girl of my figure, sadly me smalls are a little bit bigger. Still we have plenty of soap and the water is free. Nothing's better than spending a day on the river with me. Watch the willows drifting by. Yeah, to burst their buds. Why?
fish hooks.
You are as funny as anything I've seen on the halls.
I will not be laughed at by an ignorant and ugly barge woman.
One more word and I'll put you through the mangle.
Yeah, put yourself through the mangle, you old bag. And while you're at it, I'm your face and crimp it.
Oh, you really are a toad. A horrid, nasty, dirty, crawly toad. And on my nice, clean barge too. Now that is a thing I cannot have.
Is that so, my good woman? And what do you propose to do about it?
This!
Stop that toad!
As we have failed to catch Toad on the barge, we are ashamed to say he's still at large.
No doubt he thinks it funny to have pulled off such a jape.
We rue the day he got away, the greatest great escape.
Toad was weary, Toad was groggy, and he felt like the dregs. Toad was teary, Toad was soggy, he was on his last legs. Then he staggered, and he stumbled, and he fell on one knee. Then the blackguard faintly mumbled, "Please think fondly of me." Could that be the angels come to carry me afar? No, since when did angels ever drive a motor car? This is my salvation, though I've got the strangest hunch. It's that very motor car I stole that day at lunch. Their pace has slowed, this doesn't bode well. Surely now the jig is up for vain and foolish Toad.
Old lady, hello. Can you stand?
You do not know me.
Only for a poor old woman stranded by the roadside. May I assist you into the car? You seem a little better suddenly.
And I'll be better still if I could just feel the wind in my face.
How sensible.
In fact, would you let me drive the car? I was watching you coming and I found it so very interesting. I'm quite revived.
Well, if it would please you, it's simply a question of steering it while you press on that gently.
This dainty little pedal here?
That's the one.
So this pedal makes it faster. Shall we give it a burst?
Please don't meddle. You must master a few finer points first.
This is really most reviving. Come on, let's see some spark.
You are clearly bad at driving. Please pull over and park. Oh, for heaven's sake, you silly old washerwoman. Get out of the driving seat this instant.
Silly old washerwoman, don't you know who I am?
You again.
I am the brave and fearless, so juicy. I am the king of Escapology.
Let go of the wheel.
A prison cannot